What's up, vape tempers? Welcome to the Battle of the Bowls. This month, we're going to be testing bowl temperature accuracy with some of the most popular vaporizers on the market. So let's put them head to head and find out which vaporizer has the most accurate bowl temperature. First up, we have the VaporMax V5 by FlowerMate, which retails for around $120. This is the most affordable portable vaporizer in our lineup, so let's see how it does. Let's set the temperature to 380 degrees Fahrenheit. And it looks like the temperature does fluctuate quite a bit and never really achieves the temperature on the device. It appears to be pulsing the temperature up and down when it drops to a certain temperature and then moves back up. We also tested the VaporMax V8, which retails for around $135, and unfortunately we got similar fluctuating results. Alright, let's move on to the Ascent by DaVinci, which now retails at $199.99. Let's power it on and crank it up to 380 degrees Fahrenheit. As far as accuracy goes, the Ascent heats up to almost the exact temperature and stays extremely constant. It definitely is far more accurate than the FlowerMate's temperature, and what's on screen is actually what you're vaping at. Surprisingly, we found their more affordable model, the Classic DaVinci, which retails for around $129, to be equally as accurate. Moving on, at the same price point as the Ascent, we have the Alpha by GoBoof. This model has three temperature settings, a low at 374 degrees Fahrenheit, a mid at 410 degrees Fahrenheit, and a high at 428 degrees Fahrenheit. They also have two auto settings, but since we're testing accuracy, we can just skip those for now. First, let's heat it up to the low setting and see if we can hit 374 degrees Fahrenheit. Unfortunately, it looks as though the low setting is quite a bit off from what GoBoof has posted. Let's try setting 2 to see if that is more accurate. Well, it looks like this one is about 10 to 15 degrees off as well, and the difference between the low and the mid is around 50 degrees. This makes it very difficult to get an accurate temperature you'd like to vape at. Next, we have the Haze Portable Vaporizer by Haze Designs. This comes in at $249. This model features two bowls, so let's find out how accurate both of them are. We're going to set the unit to setting 2, which Haze claims is 380 degrees Fahrenheit. As you can see, the bowl temperature is similar to the FlowerMate and fluctuates up and down about 10 degrees difference. Same goes for the other side. Both bowls drop around 10 to 15 degrees, which makes for inconsistent hits. Alright, let's move on to the PAX 2, which retails for $279. The PAX 2 has a very interesting heating cycle, which you may or may not prefer. Since PAX 2 doesn't actually have exact temperatures, we are going to explain the heating pattern instead. When you put your lips on the PAX 2, it boosts the temperature up quite a bit to around 390 degrees at only setting 1. It almost seems as though it overheats and then realizes it's too hot and then comes back down. Because of this, from my experience with the unit, you get wildly inconsistent hits, which is a shame. The PAX original model is very similar, with the bowl temperature varying quite a bit while in use. Next up, we have the Arizer Air, which retails for around $259.99. This one was a little tricky to test, as the unit heats up through the glass and our temperature reader would not fit through. The temperature is probably fairly accurate. The only thing we noticed was the bottom of the Arizer did heat up much greater than the sides, so if your herb touches the bottom of the heating element, it'll fry it. We also found that the Arizer Solo, which retails for $224, yields identical results as the Air. And finally, we have our most expensive vaporizer on the market, the Crafty, which retails at a $339.99 price point. As you can see from our tests, the Crafty held up quite well, and as seen from the iOS app, held the temperature pretty constant with all around a 5-degree variance. Now, we don't have a Mighty to test, but from what the tests have showed us, the bowl temperature accuracy technology between different models of a particular company remain very similar, so I think it would be safe to assume that the Mighty is just as accurate as the Crafty. So which vaporizers are king when it comes to pinpoint accuracy and being able to buzzcraft? We are going to have to go with the Ascent by DaVinci and the DaVinci Classic. And a close second goes to the Crafty by Storz & Bickel. Both these manufacturers dominate precision temperature controls and are as accurate as a sharpshooter. Since the Ascent is almost $150 cheaper and the DaVinci is almost half the cost as the Crafty, We cannot recommend packs or alpha for vaping at specific temperatures. The FlowerMate might claim precision temperature control, but the real temperature is very inconsistent with what is displayed on screen. The Haze dual bowl system proved to be equally inconsistent as the FlowerMate's. One final thing to note is the results for the Arizer Air and Solo were too inconclusive. From my experience, you have to be careful when loading your herb that it never touches the hot plate or you will be burning your material and not vaping it. Thanks for watching the first episode of our Battle of the Bowls. Please let us know what you think in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe for more vaporizer information.